Hi, I'm going to show you how to make this bracelet. It's called the Pebble Trail Bracelet. It was actually kind of like already invented by someone else. The link to the video will be down in the description. But this bracelet is kind of more... is different because there's, instead of having one of these little circles here or a pebble on each of these, they skip one and then they put one of these circle pebbles, whatever you want to call them. This one has a circle on each of these rubber bands. You can see it. So I'm going to show you how to make this, and also how to extend it with the same exact, pretty much, bracelet. Instead of a normal extension, you'd extend it with more parts of this bracelet. So, let's begin. To make this bracelet, you're going to need your loom, your hook, two color rubber bands. I'm going to use this teal color, and I'm also going to use white. And then you will also need an S, C, or an O clip. Any clip will work. Okay, so the first thing you're going to do is you're going to make sure that the arrow on your loom is facing away from you, or pointing away from you. This arrow on the side of this, on the side of the screen right here, is going to be pointing the same direction your arrow on your loom should be facing. So now we can begin to start placing rubber bands. You can make this with any loom, but since I'm using the crazy loom, I have these two extra pegs on the end. What I'm going to do is place I'm going to place one rubber band that's going to be the color of these middle rubber bands, not these circle ones, but these. And I'm just going to put it coming off from this middle peg going out to the left or the right, whichever direction you want. And then, I'm going to get more white rubber bands and just go up the whole middle row of the loom. You could also do a zigzag pattern, but going just straight down the middle is how I'm doing it. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to turn our loom so that the arrow is facing towards you. And for this step, you're going to need to push down your rubber bands a little bit if they're kind of like crowding the top of their pegs are on. So once you've done that, you're going to get your other color, mine is teal, and these are going to be the circles that are on the bracelet. So what you're going to do is you're going to make a capping band for this part here. You're going to take a rubber band, you're going to turn it into a figure eight, or an eight, do the same thing, but then you're going to turn it back on to itself, so it will be like a circle. And then you're going to put it on the first peg. Then you're going to take another rubber band and do the same thing. Twist into an 8. And then you're going to put it on the next peg. And you're going to take another one, twist it into an 8. Make it a capping band. And put it on the next peg. And you're just going to do this the whole way down. Alright, so the last peg you're going to put a capping band on is this one at the end. You're not going to put a capping band on this peg. So now you're going to begin to loom. For this step, you're going to need your hook. Mine has a gripper on it. And you're going to make sure that the arrow is still facing towards you. And you're going to pull back the capping band, first capping band. You're going to grab the rubber band on the that's below it. So the white one for me. And you're going to pull the capping band so it doesn't come off. And pull the rubber band you have on your hook through and forwards to the next peg. And you're going to do the same thing for this peg. You're going to hold down the rubber band that is your capping band. You're going to pull back the capping band with your hook. You're going to grab the bottom rubber band, which is right below it. Pull it up, forwards, next peg. When you're looming, you have to make sure you do every peg or it'll come off and it will be really messed up. So then, you're going to go and loom. You're going to pull back the capping band, grab the bottom rubber band, and the rubber band underneath, pull it up forwards to the next peg, and you do the same thing with the peg for the next one, and you're going to do the same thing for the next one. You're just going to do this the whole way up your loom until you get to the end. When you get to the end and you have this rubber band left, you're just going to go down through. It should be the bottom rubber band, and you're just going to loom it to this peg. Now I'm going to show you how to put this rubber band on if you don't have these two pegs. So what you're going to do is you're going to take your hook, you're going to go through the rubber bands, so all of them, like so, and you're going to get a rubber band, you're going to put on your hook, you're going to pull your hook through with the rubber band on it, and make sure it's the only one on your hook. You're going to put the other end on. And this is the exact same thing as what I had before with it across these two pegs. So now you can remove your bracelet. When you go to remove your bracelet, you're going to make sure this does not fall off. So, what you're going to do is you're going to pull it off, all the rubber bands off the first hook. Make sure this rubber band that you had to move, put through all of these rubber bands is still on your hook. And make sure it stays on your hook when you pull it off and after you pull it off. So now you're going to just pull off this bracelet. Make sure you get all of them. And now you should have this bracelet. And then this right here should be the end, and the rubber band that's on your hook should still be on your hook. And so now you have your bracelet. You're going to now have to extend your bracelet. To extend this bracelet with another one of this bracelet. What you do is you basically the arrow should be facing away from you, and you would just simply make the bracelet again. And then at the end, making this chain before putting on your tapping bands. You would take this rubber band that was on your hook and just make sure it's still loomed like a teardrop, which it should be. And you would just extend it across these last two pegs. And then you would just basically put on the capping bands again. You would still put a capping band on this one right here. And then you would loom it. Don't put a capping band on this end here. So then you would loom it. And then, since there would be nothing here, you could just take this off with your hook. It'd be really awkward right there, so if you don't put it, if you don't put this on, it would just be two of these, but I did put it on, so it looks kind of awkward. And then, when you want to connect them, connect the two ends, you're going to take the end you just extended off of, you're going to stretch across any two pegs, and you grab whatever clip you have and put it on. You can take off the rubber band, and then the other end you place on any two pegs on your loom, and you put clip on that, and take it off, and then you would have your bracelet. So, thanks for watching. I really hope this you like this bracelet and you succeed in making it, and hopefully you won't be stuck with this. So, if you like the video, obviously you like the video, so like me. And that would be all, because I'm not going to subscribe for one video, but that's pretty weird. Anyway, so yeah, thanks for watching.